guys.
Winterstorm Kayla bringing a dangerous combo of snow and wind from Colorado to Minnesota. By the time it's all over, who will see more than a foot of snow? This is Weather Center Live. Good morning. I'm meteorologist Chris Warren.
And I'm meteorologist Jennifer Delgado. It is Tuesday, February the 2nd. And Chris, of course, Kayla is more than just a winter storm. We're going to be breaking down the severe side out of it. And also can't forget about the heavy rainfall for parts of the south coming up here. You are watching Weather Center Live. And it starts now.
A very dangerous threat today. This is a look at our exclusive TORCOM, the Tornado Condition Index. You look at these numbers for these cities. The bigger the number, it only goes up to 10, the bigger the threat for tornadoes. And you can see the timing right here. So there's a 60% chance of a tornado within a 50-mile radius of Tupelo, Mississippi, Memphis, Tennessee, and a 50% chance from a 50-mile radius in Birmingham, Alabama.
And our big story of the day, of course, it's winter storm Kayla bringing heavy snow. More than a foot is expected for some parts. Now, right now, more than 15 million people under some type of winter weather alert, including blizzard warnings across five states. Now, we look right now, and we have three different views. We have Goodland, Kansas. I promise you that's the scene there. You can see the roadways are actually covered with the snow, and the visibility is down. And then we have Omaha, Nebraska. And at the same time, we look at Sioux City. And a big, big difference there.
Sioux City, yeah. Wow, look at that. Okay, so let's look at the radar, because I'm looking at Sioux City.
That might be Sioux Falls. Is that Sioux Falls?
I can't. I feel like that's not Sioux City, Iowa. Because we would see, yes, Iowa City.
Okay.
We would be
because
looking
we know at, Sioux City is totally
Jim
different
Cantori
right
there now. Right.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, it is snowing really, really hard right now with thunder also at the same time in western Iowa and eastern Nebraska. Thunder snow, it's called. In fact, some of the latest observation that I saw from Omaha, their METAR, their official weather observation, included thunderstorms in their snow.
Also, when we look at the radar, the lightning detection data, there's a network that can detect when lightning happens, and it's
We've
showing up right now.
Look at all this blue right here on the map. That's snow coming down at a rate probably of 1 to 2 inches per hour. We know winds are gusting over 40 miles per hour in places. Now, if that kind of weather condition lasts for several hours, I think we will actually have met the blizzard criteria.
Which so we're seeing 3 hours.
Yes. And we're seeing very dangerous travel conditions all across the region, especially I-29 and I-80. If you don't have to travel out that way, do not do it.
And in some cases, it's impossible to be traveling.
Exactly. There is some good news, though. If you want the snow to end, there's a little bit of a dry slot coming in that way. See how the precip is ending from south to north? That's going to get into central Iowa, into Des Moines. It's not going to get as far west as eastern Nebraska. I don't think it's going to get to Sioux City. It's going to all shift eastward with time during the afternoon.
And you know, yesterday we already knew that Iowa was kind of on that tricky line with Des Moines, so we could see that.
Exactly right.
All right. Right now, we want to bring in our man, Jim Cantori. He's live right now in actually Iowa City, which we had the camera view earlier. And we do know that the winds are whipping around as well as the snow.
Oh, it's nasty out here. We're getting crushed. Hey, Postel and Chris, before I lose you both, what do you guys think of since what precedes the dry slot is this strong low-level jet? It's bringing that lift up I-35. Do we get this thunder and lightning into Rochester and maybe Minneapolis later? Maybe?
That far north,
just,
I'm not sure.
Just throwing it out there.
Yes, that far north, I'm not sure, but I would say certainly southern Minnesota and northern Iowa, yeah, it's coming your way. I think you will have that very heavy snow with the possibility of lightning in it. We're already seeing it up near Mason City. I think that's going to get into southern Minnesota.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and James, it's so close.
As we look at the radar, have you intensity pick up in the past little bit?
Absolutely, Chris. We're at a half-mile moderate right now. There's certain things I look at. There's a Perkins sign that I can still see. That would give us about a 16th of a mile. And farther down beyond that, I can't see. So that's, you know, now we're getting to actually between a quarter mile and a half mile with the moderate snow. It's the wind, though. Look at the flags. Stiff, 050 right now. That's our wind direction. Gusting over 30 miles per hour at times. So we're into this big, guys. And the snow continues to pile up. So very, very heavy snow right now. I mean, this is borderline S+. So S to S+ in terms of the observation. But the problem is the roads. I mean, there's a section of I-80 right now, Dwight South, which is where they've been in this, what you're seeing now, for hours, and where we've gotten closures. So Kearney all the way to York has got this closure going on now, and that's the bad news in through here. All right, let's time this out, because I think it's really important that everybody gets to see when they get the snow, especially Rochester and Minneapolis. This is all going to be lifting up toward you. We're pretty much in this right now. What you see is what you get for the next several hours here in Sioux City. The worst part of this storm in terms of the snowfall is actually happening right now, and it'll continue to happen right through the afternoon. So there's Minneapolis, about 2 o'clock or so, getting into you, cranking up through the Northwoods of Wisconsin, into the UP as well. Very heavy snow. Look at that dry slot, too. It goes, first you get the big snow in northern Michigan, and then boom, it just gets shut off because of that dry slot. That is a mature cyclone. That is a mature cyclone where you can whip the dry air on the bottom side of that so far that you push your moisture axis all the way to the east, and it has to wrap all the way around to the north side. And that's that north side and that west side that will stay with the snow and stay with the wind with the surface cyclone. So it's just going to be wild here. And guys, we're not even talking about the severe side of this yet. Big snow, 6 to 12, I think, for a lot of people. There will be a couple of spots that will get more than a foot. But this is a pretty fast-moving storm, and as it moves on through, the snows will taper off, but the winds will stay with us for a good part of the evening, and even into tomorrow morning, and the temperatures, too. That's another thing, guys. We started this morning at about 32 degrees. By the time tomorrow morning rolls around, we're going to be in the teens. So big change. Big change.
All right, Jim, we appreciate it. We know the road conditions are changing minute by minute, if not second by second. We're going to check in with some of the tough spots, the areas to avoid this morning, coming up next here on Weather Center Live.
Pure is big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring, because Pure tastes better.
Really? Do I even need life insurance?
Well, final expenses can be very expensive. Without insurance, the financial burden of credit card debt and funeral costs may fall to your loved ones.
Makes sense. But can I afford this kind of coverage?
MetLife's rates are affordable, and you can choose the amount of coverage that fits your needs and budget.
I've been turned down for insurance before. How's this any different?
MetLife Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance is different. In fact, you cannot be turned down for health reasons.
I'd like to get life insurance. How do I even start?
It's easy. You can apply in a single phone call with no medical questions or exams.
Will my rates go up as I get older?
Absolutely not. This coverage lasts for life. Your rates are guaranteed to never increase for the life of the policy, and your coverage will never decrease.
Guaranteed?
Guaranteed?
Guaranteed.
Yes, guaranteed. If you're age 50 to 75, MetLife Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance offers affordable coverage designed to help with final expenses, such as medical bills, credit card debt, and funeral costs. Coverage amounts range from $2,000 to $25,000. Rates start at less than $10 per month, and there are a variety of convenient payment options.
And it's from MetLife.
MetLife?
From MetLife?
That's right. Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance from MetLife.
In that case, I'm going to contact MetLife.
MetLife makes it easy to get coverage that's affordable and reliable. Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance can help you get the protection your family needs and the peace of mind you deserve.
Call 1-800-783-8155 to learn more about Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance. That's 1-800-783-8155. 1-800-783-8155.
Do you like to win?
If we're going to set the standard, it's going to be my standard.
It's go time.
I'm certain that I will make you a millionaire.
We have a deal?
We have a deal.
See what winning looks like.
That's the American dream, and that's exactly why we do this show.
Every night on the all-new CNBC.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals, low 72. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When you start linking the people side up to the weather and the science and the data, it makes a real connection and starts, I think, drive home the importance of what we do.
Hey, need fast heartburn relief? Try Cool Mint Zantac. It releases a cooling sensation in your mouth and throat. Zantac works in as little as 30 minutes. Nexium can take 24 hours. Try Cool Mint Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Had a headache, but now I don't. Excedrin is fast.
In fact, for some, relief starts in just 15 minutes. Excedrin, now available in gel tabs.
Lips appear to age faster than other skin.
No worries.
Now there's new ChapStick Total Hydration. Its 100% natural age-defying formula is clinically proven to provide healthier, more youthful looking lips.
ChapStick, put your lips first.
Lots of vitamins A and C, and only 50 calories a serving. Good morning, indeed. V8, veggies for all.
Over 40, feeling tired, losing muscle and even romantic drive? Man up with Ageless Mayo. Natural ingredients clinically shown to support energy, promote muscle, and boost free testosterone.
The great thing about Ageless Mayo is that it works.
Man up with Ageless Mayo.
Right now it's time for the Northeast forecast here on Weather Center Live, and we're going to start off with something you're going to have to be dealing with in the coming days. On the left, flood watch right now, dealing with some sunshine, but notice the temperatures. You're well above freezing in parts of Pennsylvania and New England. That helping to melt some snow combined with some rain that's going to move in, leading to that flood threat.
Yeah, that's right. And when you look at some of these areas, we still have equivalent. We're looking at some of these locations, 1 to 3 inches. We're going to see that rain moving through, especially as we go through Wednesday. And that's just the northeast. Southeast is going to be looking at some heavy rain as well. We'll get to that coming up. Well, winter storm Kayla is tracking into the upper Midwest. Let's check on some of the current conditions. And we do know that those winds have been gusting in some of those locations up to, 52 right now in Grand Isle.
You look at the radar, so anywhere you see blue, that's snow. The darker blue is the heavier snow. You see some lightning in the blue. That's thunder snow. But what's important is what you don't see happening here, but we have listed for you the wind. With some of these wind gusts around 50 miles an hour, sustained upwards of 40 miles an hour, it is dangerous to be on the roads.
Of course, and that means, of course, trying to travel in this is going to be impossible for some parts. We already do know that some of the roadways and highways are shut down across parts in Nebraska, and we want to talk more about that.
We do, with that threat for some dangerous weather. We do have an update now for you from Craig Bargfried with the Iowa Department of Transportation joining us now on the phone. Craig, how are things right now across Iowa? Any trouble spots you're really focused on at the moment?
Yes, as you mentioned, there's road closures in Nebraska, which is causing problems in Iowa as well. So we have been notifying via our digital message signs, social media, of the closures in Nebraska so that travelers can take notice and alter their plans accordingly. Right now in our southwestern part of our state, we're seeing lots of issues due to the blowing snow, as you mentioned.
And so tell us, so, you know, how have you been out there treating the roadways, especially right along the highways?
Well, we've been having our staff out on the road since actually yesterday, pre-treating, putting down brine. And as the storm started in the southwestern part of the state, our staff was out operating on the system pretty much overnight and into this morning.
Craig, we have about 30 seconds. What's your biggest challenge going forward and the message to any travelers today?
The biggest challenge as we see it is going to be the winds. As the system moves through today, winds are estimated in the sustained 20 to 30 mile an hour range with gusts up to 40 to 50. So blowing and drifting out in the open areas are going to be a huge problem and concern.
All right, that's Craig Barkfred with the Iowa Department of Transportation. I want to thank him so much for joining us. And, you know, even though they're not under, say, if you're under a blizzard warning, doesn't mean that the conditions aren't going to be impossible or dangerous to drive in.
You can still have whiteout conditions, especially with that drifting snow. Mm-hmm. It can come seemingly out of nowhere at times as well.
That's right. Well, Kayla is generating a very dangerous severe weather threat, and we're going to be timing that out.
Right, we're going to go in-depth on where there's the greatest threat for tornadoes today and where Dr. Greg Forbes has numbers as high as 5 and 6.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
You want to lose weight? Here's some things you should know. Lose up to 3 times more body fat in 1 month than dieting on your own. Weight loss of just 8% can help reduce your risk for heart disease.
Introducing the all-new Turbo 10. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. You'll love it. Money back guaranteed.
Did you know that losing weight on Nutrisystem can help you lower your blood pressure by 7 points in 1 month? Improve your sleep quality by 19% in 1 month.
Lose 7% of your body weight and lower your risk of diabetes by 58%. So you can have more energy, sleep better, and burn more belly fat.
Bust that gut.
My energy level is through the roof.
I sleep so much better.
My doctor is so happy.
Order your 28-day plan right now. With Turbo 10, you'll get delicious meals and 1 week of our all-new Turbo Shakes free, packed with protein and probiotics to help support digestive health and bust belly bloat.
The shakes, so good.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
Plus 1 week of our NutriCrush shakes to crush hunger free.
Forget about fad diets. It's important to have the right amount of carbs, fats, and proteins to fuel your body. And Nutrisystem has everything you need.
Yo-yo diets. Forget about it.
Lose weight fast, have more energy, and get healthy.
I absolutely feel sexier now than I did when I was in my 30s.
I gained energy, stamina, endurance.
Now I'm taking the stairs.
Call or click now, and we'll rush you Turbo 10 today with 14 free shakes. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. Money back guaranteed.
I owe my weight loss to Nutrisystem, 100%.
10 years later, and I'm feeling great.
Do what I did. Call Nutrisystem and start looking and feeling great today.
Pick up the phone and call Nutrisystem now.
Call 877-920-DIET right now and get the all-new Turbo 10 with 14 shakes free.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
At The Watershed, we believe in recovery. We believe that every alcoholic and addict deserves the opportunity to be healed. Our team of addiction professionals will address the underlying causes of your addiction while treating you with dignity and respect. We've helped thousands of patients recover from this seemingly hopeless state of mind and body. Addicts can recover. Addicts do recover. No matter how hopeless the situation seems, the time to get help is now. Call The Watershed today.
Our next item is a genuine Name Your Price tool.
This highly sought-after device from Progressive can be yours for...
$20,000?
No, we are giving it away for just 3 easy payments of $4.99 plus tax.
The lines are blowing up.
We've got Deborah from Poughkeepsie.
Yeah, no, it's Flo.
you guys realize anyone can use the Name Your Price tool for free on progressive.com, right? I know it's like they're always on television. What?
842 today.
We have a charge. We have a responsibility to provide information to people to help them, help their communities, help their families stay safe. And it matters so much.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8s, powered by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram.
Not everyone wants to follow the crowd, especially when they have a truck capable of taking them farther. And that's exactly what Ram 1500 can do, with the best fuel economy. It's this kind of leadership that has more people driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts, glory, Ram.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back. We look across parts of the southeast, and it's been so incredibly warm, and people have really been enjoying this. But the problem is, with that warmth and increasing humidity, it's going to be causing some big problems. We look at Atlanta, and earlier we had a ground stop, 56 degrees. We're locked in the fog. As we show, you got that strong southerly flow.
And just based on the temperatures right now, 56 in Atlanta, 72 there in the French Quarter in New Orleans, what time of year would you think it was?
Probably late March.
Late March? Like 2 months from now.
Yeah.
But not the case. It's going to be a warm one today. Lower 70s, almost 20 degrees warmer than average in Atlanta. Nashville, almost 25 degrees warmer than average this afternoon.
It's incredible seeing those warm temperatures out. And you know what the shocking part is? When you look at areas like Jackson, Mississippi, and Jacksonville, how close those temperatures are.
Look at the camera on the top right, the Atlanta camera. Mm-hmm. You can see those are low clouds, and you can kind of see the buildings kind of peeking out just a little.
Yeah,
clearing,
and it's even brightening.
And a little bit of blue sky in the distance.
Yeah, it is.
Some low clouds.
Okay, we look at the visibility, and we do know we have quarter mile visibility at Atlanta. And Athens, zero. Look how bad that is. And here's the wide view. Normally, this is our view that we see of the city on top of the Coca-Cola building, our camera.
And this is our view today. Usually you can see the skyline. You can see one of the buildings on the right.
Which building is that?
A little bit.
Oh, there you go. Look, it's getting in view.
It's coming and going.
In and out.
Anybody, I call this the pencil building. Anybody know what this?
I don't.
What it is actually called?
No, we need to find that out.
But this is a look from atop the Coca-Cola World Headquarters here in Atlanta, Georgia. Temperatures in the 50s with some of that fog.
Do you know what's better than a temperature of 73 in Atlanta in early Feb?
74?
What? Yeah, or 73 with a dew point of 60.
Oh, okay.
That's even better.
And that's work today. We're going to be looking at those dew points going up and increasing the threat for severe weather.
Correctamundo. That's a good segue, wasn't it?
It was.
Kendall's
the doctor.
Helping us here. What'd you say again, Kendall? The Bank of America.
That's the Bank of America.
Look, there it is. Wow.
It's right coming.
And look at a little bit of blue sky.
We see another building coming through. So if you're at the airport, the point is we're going to see some improvement, but even as we go through the day, we're going to see the potential for some more delay setting up. And we add in the threat for the heavy rainfall because that front's going to be moving a little bit slower too as we go through today as well as through tomorrow.
All right, so we are seeing that big threat here for severe weather. And right in the middle, you can see the state of Mississippi.
Yeah, we do. And we do know that we have tour cons across parts of Mississippi, including Jackson, as well as even into parts of Alabama. Tour cons of 6 today, a severe threat for tornadoes.
Steve Wilkinson with the National Weather Service in Jackson, Mississippi, is joining us now on the phone with the big threat there and for some local perspective. So at the National Weather Service, what are you looking at today? What do you think is going to be the most interesting thing to watch play out throughout the day?
Sure. Well, this morning we have what's called a cap in meteorological terms, which is just a lid to keep storms from developing. We're already 70 degrees with a very high moisture content, so the ingredients are really there as the wind energy picks up today. So it's kind of got a lid on it now. We're going to wait to see exactly how that lid kind of lifts and the storms start to break out by this afternoon. So that's always kind of the trick of trying to figure out exactly what's going to happen. But once it does, we feel like the storms will be on the severe side.
And we're talking about the storms and the threat for tornadoes. I mean, that's really something that's going to be great, especially some of these even coming into the overnight hours.
Right. Once the storms develop down here, we expect that many of them will be in a supercell type mode, which of course is favorable for tornadoes and even strong tornadoes. So we'll be watching that very closely, and the time frame for that is later in the afternoon and getting into the evening when it starts to get dark, and like you said. So that's certainly a big concern we have, and we definitely want people in this area to keep an eye on what's going on.
All right, Steve Wilkinson, meteorologist with the National Weather Service in Jackson, Mississippi. Thank you for your perspective. And again, with a lot of these storms happening after dark, it's important you know what to do. Mm-hmm. Coming up in about 15, 20 minutes, we're going to talk about some of the things you need to know to keep your family safe when storms threaten at night.
That's right. And there's also a severe side coming with a snowstorm out of Kayla. We're talking blizzard conditions across parts of the plains and the Midwest. We'll have more when we come back.
Well, the squirrels are back in the attic.
Mom?
Your dad won't call an exterminator.
Can I call you back, Mom?
He says it's personal this time.
If you're a mom, you call at the worst time. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
Where are you? It's very loud there. Are you taking a Zumba class?
It takes a lot of work to run this business, but I really love it. I'm on the move all day long. And sometimes, I just don't eat the way I should. So I drink Boost to get the nutrition that I'm missing.
Boost Complete Nutritional Drink has 26 essential vitamins and minerals, including calcium and vitamin D to support strong bones, and 10 grams of protein to help maintain muscle, all with a great taste.
I don't plan on slowing down anytime soon.
Stay strong, stay active with Boost.
Moved into this? Make it look like this. Let's check out our options. Give it some style. Perfect. Now, let's detail it. Let's put our ideas to work and step into a new favorite room. Let's do this. Buy vanities in-store and online today, starting at just $139. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Dyson V6 vacuum. No cord, just powerful suction.
You're getting 3 here.
Uh-huh.
All right, here goes.
Oh. Cheddar, sour cream and onion, and salt and vinegar.
Wow.
How did you do that?
I can see through the blindfold.
Pringles! Here's something new. Now you can get the Weather Channel forecasts on the new L.L. Bean app. Just tap, shop, and discover. From L.L. Bean, featuring forecasts from the Weather Channel. Download today.
There's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies Plus Energy Support. It's a new fiber supplement that helps support regularity and includes B vitamins to help convert food to energy.
Mm, these are good.
Nice work, Philips.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
What you doing?
Just prepping for my boss's party in a couple weeks.
What are those?
Pressed white strips. They whiten way better than paste.
Crisp 3D white strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste.
I'd say someone's making quite an impression.
Crisp 3D white strips, the way to whiten.
Yeah, severe weather is I think when the Weather Channel really shines. You see everyone come together during severe weather events. What it comes down to is that this weather is affecting people. When you start linking the people side up to the weather and the science and the data, it makes a real connection and starts, I think, drive home the importance of what we do.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone, your premier hearing care partner.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
On Weather Center Live, winter storm Kayla pulling away from the western states this morning. Now its energy moving into the heartland. Top left, here's Belmont, Arizona, and Bennett, Colorado in the top right. And New Mexico from the air, showing you the extent of the snowfall.
You know what you could do with that Belmont, Arizona camera? You could transplant that right now to parts of northern Iowa and Nebraska, and it looks like that, except now that the daylight is in.
Yeah, that's right. You know, they felt the wrath of Kayla first. Well, as we look, the top right, Bennett, Colorado, that's just a suburb just east of Denver, right along Interstate 70. Now, closed at Bennett this morning all the way over to the Kansas state line, and we do know Goodland, Kansas, was having some big problems there this morning. Colorado? So anywhere between 2 inches and 25 inches in the mountain range.
And do you know what you can do with the camera on the bottom here, Dr.
Let's
Postel?
See. What can I do? Can I move it?
No, you can see perspective-wise what it looks like when you get up high and you see all
drone?
Of the snow. Yeah,
it's
from yesterday in Angel
Fire.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
So up there, a fresh, more than a foot of snow, almost a foot and a half, 16 inches of snow there. So you're getting the snow in the mountains where you probably, you know, you expect it or even you want it. Right.
Right.
But other areas you might expect it but might not want it is the spots where you're traveling today.
Mm-hmm. Some of those low-lying areas.
There's interstates all across the plains in the upper Midwest that are going to be very difficult to travel on today, including I-80. Mm-hmm. You know, as part of it is closed in Nebraska, across Iowa going on I-80, north out of Des Moines on I-35. That's trouble. Too,
that's so. Right. And then the National Department of Transportation, or I should say Iowa Department of Transportation, said it was causing a backup into Iowa as well from what's happening in Nebraska. So big time problems. Mm-hmm.
Well, let's take a look at what's happening right now with Winter Storm Kayla, where the snow is coming down. The snow in blue and on the right in Omaha, Nebraska. Looks like you're up in the Sierra Nevada mountains, but that's not the case there. Doesn't it?
It does look like
a mountain scene in Omaha.
Right.
And in Ames, Iowa, more of a typical plains look. However, a lot of snow. Temperatures right around the freezing mark as well. And some lightning showing up, Dr. Postel.
How about that? A little lightning back in the cold air. There's some instability aloft in a very shallow layer that is allowing some pretty strong upward motion right in that blue area. We're looking at basically cloud tops still less than 25,000 feet. So it's not like the summertime thunderstorms. It's a different sort of breed.
Jen?
Different type of breed, and we want to bring in our storm tracker, Jim Cantore. He's live in Sioux City, Iowa right now. And Jim, I just checked the observations, and I know you're still under the blizzard criteria. You're just under the criteria for that, but I think it doesn't matter when we're looking at conditions like that right now.
I mean, we're definitely S+, I can tell you that. I can't see that Perkins sign I was talking about that's about a 16th of a mile. Believe it or not, behind me, that is Interstate 29. And it's kind of interesting because it's gotten real quiet there, okay? I'm not really sure why. I mean, sometimes they come in droves in terms of the traffic, but sometimes we go periods without a lot of travel. Now, there's a kind of a side road, if you will, that you just see trucks going by me, one with a plow on that's being plowed as we speak. But I have not seen a lot of action on the interstate right now. We are into heavy, heavy snow. You're right, Jen. We're not at blizzard criteria. We're not seeing those winds, if you will, at 35 miles per hour for three straight hours. We've gusted to 30 knots, but we haven't seen sustained winds. So we're kind of waiting on the wind energy with this thing. Not surprisingly that it could get here certainly before too long. But this is definitely the heaviest snow that we've had. No question. Pretty hard to measure here. It's been blowing around a little bit. I'm trying to get down to the asphalt here. I mean, there's a couple of inches here. But, you know, I go over here. And, I mean, it's more like 4 inches on the ground, so it's much, much deeper in different spots because it's just blowing and drifting around. I mean, I'm in an open parking lot at the beautiful Tyson Event Center here. They were nice enough to give us their parking lot to broadcast from, but it's pretty hard to measure here. I mean, guys, just look around. Look at the front of the center. I mean, you can hardly see. You can see how low the visibilities are. Just not a lot of distance. It's probably about, 100 yards to the edge of that building over there from where I'm standing, if that, maybe 80, 85 to 90. Either way, there's just not a lot of viewing beyond that in terms of the visibility. There goes one truck on the interstate right there. All right, there comes another couple of vehicles. So they're moving along, I would say, 35, 40 miles per hour right now in terms of the speed, but nobody's going anywhere. We're getting crushed. Let's talk about the radar here and get into this a little bit because it is certainly something I want everybody to see. Now, notice where we are in Sioux City. We're in Sioux City, Iowa. We're sitting right down here below Sioux Falls. Even though we're getting precip coming towards Sioux Falls, it is not snowing there yet, or even just to the south. So a little bit of that is actually Virga. So the air is very, very dry. It's only 25 degrees up there. We're at 30, believe it or not. And down toward Omaha, they were actually starting off at about 34 degrees this morning when it first started snowing. And then, of course, the bottom dropped out with all the thunder and lightning. But I-29, where we are, Interstate 80 to my south, Kearney, especially over to York, which is closed, and really everybody over to Des Moines. I really don't recommend people travel on this today, especially with these kind of visibilities that we're getting here in Sioux City. This is pretty uniform over eastern Nebraska and west central Iowa as well. This will be moving up into Minnesota and also southeastern South Dakota. All right, guys, let's go back to you in the studio.
All right, Jim Cantore live in Sioux City. You know, and just be forward when we start to talk to you at the beginning of the hour, we can see the visibility has dropped tremendously with that heavier snow band working through. And for more of that, we're going to turn it over to Dr. Greg Postel and Chris.
And just a couple of states away from where Jim is right now, there is a tornado threat today. Serious threat for severe weather. Tornadoes, a strong possibility. Some of the tornadoes themselves could be strong and lasting into the overnight hours.
Right. And so if you look at our area of severe weather that we've outlined here in red, where it's most likely to occur, I think even inside of that, we could draw an area that is probably most likely to see tornadoes. And I would offer up here that Mississippi is probably at most risk to see tornadoes later on this afternoon, and also western Alabama, maybe even southern Tennessee. You can see this powerhouse circulation winding up, Chris. This is basically the circulation at high altitudes. The core of the upper storm is right out here, but the air out ahead of it, you were mentioning, is of a totally different variety. It is getting warmer and more humid out there on the warm side of this storm, enough so to support thunderstorms, big ones, later on today with the instability kind of at the low to medium range, typical perhaps of early February. Thank goodness this is not May and we'd see high levels of instability, because when you combine that with the amount of wind shear that we have at play, those two ingredients together are what you need to support severe weather. And we have a lot of wind shear and not so much instability, so that's going to put some limit on it. But if this were high instability, high shear, I'd be really, really worried. But right now, it looks like more really dominated by the strong wind shear.
But put it in perspective, though, it's also early February, and this is significant for this time of year.
Correct. So what I've placed on here is the area that's outlined by the sort of white line. This is where the air mass is going to be unstable enough to support all modes of severe weather, including tornadoes. There's the state of Mississippi. But you see the red lines in there. That is the wind aloft, say at about 10,000 feet, and the wind at the surface is coming in a different direction like that. So if you can imagine that there's already kind of this rolling motion. motion in the atmosphere that if the thunderstorms grow in it, they could tilt it up in that direction, which would mean you'd have thunderstorms that rotate. Those are called supercells, and those can produce tornadoes.
Quick look at the timing.
Let's do that. There's a front, cold front. We're going to be watching right along it, especially later on this afternoon in Mississippi, for producing severe thunderstorms, triggering them, and also some storms out ahead of them. We have to watch out for that too. But really, all modes in play through about 8 or 9 o'clock, and then we begin to see the line of thunderstorms along the cold front take over, and that would sort of transfer our primary threat to high winds right along with it. So there we go, as we go through the early morning hours tomorrow. Watch out, Atlanta rush hour, could be some big storms moving through.
And the threat happening overnight as well. We're going to take a look at some of what you need to know to keep your family safe when thunderstorms and tornadoes threaten at night.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
My mom loves giving me advice. She even gives me advice about my toothpaste and mouthwash, but she's a dentist, so I kind of have to listen. She said, Jen, go pro with Crest Pro Health Advanced.
Advanced to healthier gums and stronger teeth from day one.
Using Crest toothpaste and mouthwash makes my whole mouth feel awesome, and my teeth are stronger too.
Crest Pro Health Advanced is superior to Colgate Total in these five areas dentists check.
This checkup, so good.
Go pro with Crest Pro Health Advanced.
Mom's right. Again.
Pure is big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring, because Pure tastes better.
Get fast-acting, long-lasting relief from heartburn with doctor-recommended Gaviscon. It neutralizes stomach acid and is the only product that forms a protective barrier that helps keep stomach acid in the stomach where it belongs. For fast-acting, long-lasting relief, try Gaviscon.
Before there could be a nation, there had to be people willing to fight for it, to take on the world's greatest challenges, whatever they might be. So the U.S. Army masters not only tactics and strategy, but also physics and chemistry. We make battle plans and create breakthroughs in medicine, science, and engineering. Our next mission could be anything, so we prepare for everything.
It's just a cough.
If you could see your cough, you'd see just how far it can spread. Robitussin DM Max soothes your throat and delivers fast, powerful cough relief. Robitussin DM Max, because it's never just a cough.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest lasting Energizer Max ever.
Really, do I even need life insurance?
Well, final expenses can be very expensive. Without insurance, the financial burden of credit card debt and funeral costs may fall to your loved ones.
Makes sense, but can I afford this kind of coverage?
MetLife's rates are affordable, and you can choose the amount of coverage that fits your needs and budget.
I've been turned down for insurance before. How's this any different?
MetLife Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance is different. In fact, you cannot be turned down for health reasons.
I'd like to get life insurance. How do I even start?
It's easy. You can apply in a single phone call with no medical questions or exams.
Will my rates go up as I get older?
Absolutely not. This coverage lasts for life. Your rates are guaranteed to never increase for the life of the policy, and your coverage will never decrease.
Guaranteed?
Guaranteed?
Guaranteed.
Yes, guaranteed. If you're age 50 to 75, MetLife Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance offers affordable coverage designed to help with final expenses such as medical bills, credit card debt, and funeral costs. Coverage amounts range from $2,000 to $25,000. Rates start at less than $10 per month, and there are a variety of convenient payment options.
And it's from MetLife.
MetLife?
From MetLife?
That's right. Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance from MetLife.
In that case, I'm going to contact MetLife.
MetLife makes it easy to get coverage that's affordable and reliable. Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance can help you get the protection your family needs and the peace of mind you deserve.
Call 1-800-796-8445 to learn more about Guaranteed Acceptance Whole Life Insurance. That's 1-800-796-8445. 1-800-796-8445.
Well, this is video actually coming in from California, Ventura County. Weekend storms and heavy rainfall flooded parts of Highway 101 and the vicinity of the Solamar burn area.
And you may remember that fire burned more than 1,000 acres in Ventura last December, but still not a lot of vegetation or ground cover to help keep all of the mud and rocks up in the hills. Instead, when you get some of this heavy rain, it comes down, and this turns out to be the scene that you get.
Yeah, look how deep that water is. It's just coming down off the mountains. You can see people driving through it. I mean, that is just really just a testament to how badly the situation is there with the burn scars. You can see flooding like that and why we say the danger.
Time for your Southwest forecast right now as we take a look at the forecast on the left. Right now, what you're seeing, some rain moving in to parts of California, Nevada, and a live look at a chilly Los Angeles, 40 degrees. Beautiful start to the day. Flagstaff, it's cold. 8 with some snow.
Yeah, it seems like Flagstaff's always been cold, really, for the whole month. As we show you for right now, the temperature right now, 8 degrees. I know we're in day 2, but in January, we had a good amount of snowfall as well there. And then for Los Angeles, a gorgeous look. It's nice to see that sunshine, especially coming out of that video of the flooding there. Well, we talk more about the severe weather threat.
And there is a serious threat today. Some strong storms and tornadoes a possibility. Let's take a look at the areas tonight. So we have that threat developing later on this afternoon and this evening, but also tonight. We're showing you this because keep in mind it's going to be dark. You can't see the storms when it's dark out. And also a lot of times people are sleeping and you don't. Nocturnal stuff. So there are a lot of inherent threats when it comes to severe weather, and it gets even worse when people are either asleep or can't see the tornadoes.
Yeah, and we show you right now, we do know that we're going to have some torr counts of 4, but some of those are up to 6, and we're talking that 6% chance. Well, we do know that severe weather outbreak is going to happen later on tonight. We want to make sure you are aware. Julia Barton tells us why.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
They are terrifying even in broad daylight. When a tornado hits in the middle of the night, there's little time to think. Harrisburg, Illinois is a perfect example. A tornado struck in the early morning hours on February 29th, 2012, killing 8.
Of course, we were sleeping, thinking, okay, we got to get up in the morning and go to work.
Alice Retzloff and her family survived thanks to her daughter. She'd stayed up all night following the radar and warnings on TV.
She came in about 4:30 and said, okay, we got to get in the basement. It's headed for us.
Remaining vigilant overnight is the best way to stay safe. You can't rely on a tornado siren to jar you from sleep. There's no national requirement for sirens, and many areas don't have them.
Having a NOAA weather radio or signing up for wireless alerts, even push notifications from the Weather Channel app, can help keep you safe.
Being ready for this next severe system is critical, so go over your family's weather plan now. If you don't have a basement, be sure to seek shelter in a small, windowless first floor interior room, like a closet or bathroom. I'm meteorologist Julie Martin, the Weather Channel.
Some very important information because of what we're going to see tonight. Let's take a look at the timing and where the storms are going to be and when. So here it is this evening at 7 o'clock. You can see this line of storms. It's dark. So everything you're seeing here is in the dark. Put this into motion and you can see parts of Mississippi and into parts of Tennessee and then the Ohio Valley. Some of the strongest storms happening before the late shows are coming on TV and then through Nashville after midnight, or at least close to and after midnight for you. And then by tomorrow morning, like like early morning. If you have to get up really early for work, say like 3 o'clock in the morning from Birmingham over to Atlanta, it's that 3 to 7 o'clock in the morning time frame. Again, still dark and still going to see this big line of storms. And again, some of these do have the potential of having tornadoes associated with it. So take Julie's advice and do what you have to do to be alerted and be in a safe place.
Yeah, and seek shelter, especially if you're in a mobile home. Well, severe weather, of course, is going to be happening across parts of the South, but blizzard conditions across parts of the plains in the Midwest. Coming up, we'll let you know where the most dangerous travel is happening right now, as well as on your way home. And where we could see a foot of snowfall.
That's right. We are looking live right here near Grand Island, Nebraska, 29 degrees. This shot coming from behind a plow. Be safe out there.
Discover Card.
Hey, so I'm looking at my bill and my FICO credit score is on here?
Yeah, we give you your FICO credit score for free.
Awesome sauce.
The only person I know that says that is Lisa.
Julie?
We've already given more than 306 million FICO credit scores for free to our card members. Apply today at discover.com.
And action!
Cut. But seriously, Hail Caesar, rated PG-13.
I am never getting married.
We're never having kids.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Let me get you ready for the day weather-wise.
We've got a lot going on this morning.
Definitely see what kind of pattern we've had.
So start your morning routine with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jan Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
It is a team here at the Weather Channel and an awesome team at that.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
And you can't see clearly for 1 second at 60 miles per hour, you can't see clearly for 88 feet. And a lot can happen in 88 feet. That's why Bosch created the Icon with ClearMax 365. It's a rubber technology for longer lasting performance, not found on any other wiper blade. Because like you, Bosch cares about what's ahead.
Bosch Icon Wiper Blades with ClearMax 365.
Now you can create your own tour of Italy at Olive Garden, starting at $12.99. Choose 3 of 10 favorites to enjoy on one plate, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. The best tour of Italy is the one you create at Olive Garden.
Hey. You're gonna do great.
Hi.
Many sleep aids have pain medicine, but ZzzQuil is different. Because why would you take a pain medicine when all you want is good sleep? ZzzQuil, a non-habit-forming sleep aid that's not for pain, just for sleep.
Lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Smoothie Mix. Replace a meal with delicious new flavors like creamy chocolate with 20 grams of protein, as low as 1 gram of sugar, and 100% daily fiber.
Welcome to Azure.
The Palm Beach Gardens address, where waterfront living has been perfected. 14 acres of refined living with concierge services and unequaled resort amenities. And best of all, the most extraordinary contemporary condominium residences you can imagine. Reservations are now being taken in our final building. Azure, waterfront living perfected.
When you're on hold, your business is on hold. That's why Comcast Business doesn't leave you there. When you call, a small business expert will answer you in about 30 seconds. No annoying hold music. Just a real person, real fast, whenever you need them. So your business can get back to business. Sounds like my ride's ready.
Don't get stuck on hold. Reach an expert fast. Comcast Business, built for business.
0291 now.
I think what makes the Weather Channel's coverage unique is that we are meteorologists. We know the weather, and that makes a tremendous difference.
Right now, this is a live look from the road near Grand Island, Nebraska, sort of in the southwest central part of Nebraska. Looks like a car's off the side of the road. That's not going anywhere anytime soon. The person we're following right now, Chris Heater, in the car, and we are following a plow. You don't want to pass plows.
Yeah, stay behind them.
Stay behind
them.
They're
clearing the road for you.
That's exactly right. They're like the lead blocker.
Right.
Like blocking the wind for you, absolutely. And we do know this is an area off of Route 2, and we have Chris Heater on the phone. Now, Chris, we do know that conditions there are, blizzard conditions. Winds right now 52, blowing that snow around. Describe to us the roadways.
Pretty much most of the roads are shut down. They shut down Interstate 80, I believe, from Kearney all the way to Lincoln. That's what actually forced me to get off here at Grand Island. And I think what they're doing right now is plowing a way for people to get into town to get a hotel or get some food, because at this point with road conditions, no one's really going anywhere right now.
Chris, have you noticed the wind?
Oh, yeah. Wind is really nasty. I want to say probably gusting 50 miles an hour at least. I don't have a wind meter on me, but I think that there's probably some higher gusts, close to 60.
But, Chris, can you feel it, like when you're driving, tugging on your car?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's tried pushing me, because with the wet snow, it's compacting and turning to pure ice. And while I was driving down I-80, it actually tried to push me off the road a couple of times.
And, you know, we check the observations, and the observation actually says that there's no snow right now, but it's saying freezing fog. But, you know, describe to us what you're seeing conditions-wise.
Right now, condition-wise, it is definitely snowing. Mm-hmm. Probably 1 to 2 inches an hour right now. There was some thunder snow probably about an hour ago in the vicinity. And the wind actually seems to be kind of kicking up a little more than compared to like an hour or two ago. But if anything, the conditions are worsening.
Chris, we saw when we first took your live feed, there was a car off to the side of the road. Have you noticed many accidents, stranded vehicles, that sort of a thing? Or is it more typical of what you're seeing right now, what you have seen? Kind of just not very many cars on the road.
Yeah, there haven't been too many cars on the road. Actually, about 20 minutes before there was a couple semis that I was following behind when we got off of Interstate 80. They lost their momentum and they got stuck trying to get off of the interstate. But for the most part, I think everyone's kind of staying off of the roads. I haven't seen too many vehicles that were stuck, but there have been mainly semis actually that I've seen that have been stuck.
Hey, Chris, a personal question. How does this compare to maybe, say, some of the other blizzards or snowstorms you've covered in the past?
I'd have to say this one kind of ranks towards the top. I was out in the Northeast on that most recent blizzard. They had a lot of snow, but not the wind. And this one, they have had a lot of snow and the wind with it at the same time. So I guess this probably ranks up towards the top.
And really quickly, Chris, does the terrain itself being flat, does that help things when you're driving around, or the fact that the winds might be a little bit stronger, does that make things more difficult?
It makes things more difficult. It's basically preventing any sort of wind breaks other than small patches of trees, but with how flat it is out here, it's making the road conditions and visibility conditions much worse than, you know, compared to like a hilly area.
All right, Chris Heater, Storm Tracker, there we are following near Grand Island, Nebraska. Thank you very much for your report, and stay safe out there.
Yeah, you know, we're happy to see there aren't a lot of cars out there, but you know, there's always somewhere that somebody's always trying to hit the roads. So again, be careful, because blizzard conditions are going to continue as we go throughout the day. Well, the other side of winter storm, Kayla, severe storms, Chris, right?
That's right. We're going to break down the timing of some of the strongest storms, including that tornado threat. Also coming up in just a couple of minutes, we're going to get back to timing out the locations and some of the worst weather, including a Torcon of 6, a 60% chance of a tornado within a 50-mile radius of Memphis, Tennessee. Also, Storm Tracker Jim Cantore is live in the thick of the snow. We'll check in with him coming up.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Winter storm Kayla bringing a dangerous combo of snow and wind. From Colorado to Minnesota, by the time it's all over, who will see more than a foot of snow? This is Weather Center Live. Good morning. I'm meteorologist Chris Warren.
And I'm meteorologist Jennifer Delgado. It is Tuesday, February the 2nd. And of course, Chris, we are tracking Kayla, a major winter storm, but we're also breaking down the severe side, because we're going to be looking at the threat for tornadoes as we set up and go later into the day and even overnight hours.
Storm specialist Dr. Greg Postel is here with a closer look at that, Dr. Postel.
Yeah.
And it's interesting, regardless of what time of year it is, there's a pretty significant threat for tornadoes today.
Yeah, I would say Mississippi, parts of maybe southern Tennessee, western Alabama. Watch out later on today. Tornadoes, a real risk.
We have it all covered for you here on Weather Center Live as you look at the Torcons right now.
And we do know some of the Torcons today, 6. These are the highest that we've seen all year long. Those include Tupelo, Mississippi, as well as Memphis and big cities impacted. And Birmingham, 5 for you. You can see a lot of these coming in the afternoon and going even into 2 a.m.
And remember, the scale only goes up to 10. So the bigger the number, the bigger the threat. And a 6 out of 10 is a 60% chance of a tornado within a 50-mile radius of Tupelo, Mississippi, Memphis, Tennessee, and Birmingham, Alabama. There's a 50% chance of a tornado within a 50-mile radius.
All right, well, our big story right now, of course, is winter storm Kayla. It's bringing the heavy snowfall around. We have 3 views for you coming out of Goodland, Kansas, as well as into Omaha, Nebraska, and Sioux City, Iowa.
Right now, more than 15 million people are under some sort of a winter weather alert. This also includes blizzard warnings across 5 states. And again, we're looking live at Goodland, Omaha, Sioux City. You can see all of the snow that's coming down. Temperatures right around the freezing mark. And Dr. Greg Postel is watching this, watching winter storm Kayla. There has been quite a bit of lightning associated with this. So this is a rather intense storm overall. Dr. Postel, what has stood out to you the most, you think, this morning as we've been watching the storm?
2 things. The amount of lightning in the cold side, I think that surprised me a little bit. I figured we'd get some, but there's a lot of lightning strikes there where it is snowing. There is instability to be had in the atmosphere, generally between about 15,000 feet and 20,000 feet. There's a little layer in there where if the air parcels can get lifted that high, they will accelerate kind of upward, but on an ascending path that's curving around the cyclone. So actually, air, what I mean by that is coming around like this and then rising really quickly right in here, boom, and where it's ascending quickly, that is producing those vigorous sort of motions in the atmosphere enough to produce those thunderstorms. That's kind of what we're seeing there, and there's a lot of that. The other part that we're watching closely is the progress of this dry slot. You see how there's no precipitation across parts of Kansas and northwestern Missouri? That dry slot's going to be keeping, is going to be moving northward during the morning hours. It's going to get to Des Moines. They're going to, it's going to shut down their precip, but back in here where the dry slot doesn't reach, it is going to continue to snow pretty hard as everything sort of gradually shifts eastward during the day.
And the area circled here, we do have someone in the field, not just someone, the man, storm tracker Jim Cantore, live in Sioux City. Wow, Jim, it looked like things were pretty bad before when we checked in with you. It looks like things are getting even worse.
Yeah, we're getting hammered here, guys. I won't even lie about it. This is S plus at its finest. And, you know, we got, I mean, the good news is I can see plows out working. I can see cars on the side road here, the off ramp of I-29, but it's just miserable out there. Actually, come on in. I'm sorry, what was your name?
Dino,
come here, come talk to me. I want you to tell everybody what it was like, because you just pulled in off the road.
Well, it was slippery and sliding all the way. And I saw cars on the side of the road, and it was pretty deep snow.
Were you on the interstate?
No, I was not on the interstate.
Okay, so secondary roads, and they're just, they're a mess.
Secondary, they're a mess, yeah. I was lucky to get here.
All right, so even though we're not at blizzard, okay, we're not like officially at the blizzard or everything, we are still gusting 20, 30 miles per hour. What is it like when you get a gust and that snow just whooshes across the road?
Well, it doesn't feel good because you can't hardly see anything. It's pretty much a whiteout.
All right. Well, Dino, thanks, buddy. Be safe. We will talk to you in a minute when I get off the air, but thank you for coming on impromptu. Guys, you can see what it's like out here. I mean, I'll back out a little bit, but I don't want to go too far because I know my microphone's going to come out of range. As a matter of fact, we actually had to change microphones. Usually I go with what we call a lavalier, is one you can pin on you, but I've got handheld just simply because it's doing much better out here than the lav was, because we had to bury it in my jacket here. But, I mean, it's just, you can see how just I mean, what am I? Petarac, what am I, about 25 yards? Yeah. Okay, it's about 25 yards from you. You can see how, it's me, hello, it's just me out here. I mean, holy smoke, man, it's just reduced visibility galore out and through here. So I-80, I-29, let's go back to the radar. I'm going to walk back toward the camera here because I want to see this. Jess, do me a favor, pull down that current radar a little bit. I want to see how far that thunder and lightning is from the actual... I gotta clear off my monitor. There's snow accumulating on the monitor. So there it is, right there. I want to see if it got up toward the Minnesota line yet. Not quite. So a couple of pockets, of course, just to my northeast. So guys, you know, thunder and lightning and thunder snow is not an automatic here. I mean, it doesn't happen for hours on end. Even though I did read a story from a friend of mine in Flagstaff, and he was telling me how he got it for about two. They were getting on and off thunder and lightning for 2 hours the other day with this storm. So it's very, very dynamic. This is just a part of the dynamics that's helping to produce the snowy side. And as you can see, the wind is blowing around like crazy. So Minneapolis, again, after lunch, you're in it. Wisconsin, Green Bay, La Crosse, you're in it this afternoon. Even though La Crosse, you'll probably get dry slotted a little bit, but I think Green Bay, the Northwoods, you guys are all going to get crushed up there. So big time snow, guys. Tough to travel out and through here. The good news is I'm calling this kind of a warm blizzard because temperatures aren't that bad. We're about 30 degrees right now, so that doesn't feel that bad. But tomorrow morning, as the storm pulls away, the cold air will dump in, and we'll get down to the upper teens and low 20s. It'll be a much different story, especially with that wind kicking up still this afternoon and tonight. So long after the snow ends, guys, long after the snow ends, we will continue to see the blowing, the drifting snow, much like we heard about, causing treacherous travel today. I mean, look at this. Just from the time I started, you guys threw it to me.
Yeah.
Look at my goggles. I already got accumulation.
Look at the beard.
Woo! We'll be right back. Kayla.
Moved into this? Make it look like this. Let's check out our options. Give it some style. Perfect. Now, let's detail it. Let's put our ideas to work and step into a new favorite room. Let's do this. Buy vanities in-store and online today, starting at just $139. The Home Depot. More saving. More doing.
Haven't seen Maggie in months. Sitting in with time on my hands. Loneliness, place tricks with my mind. Everything that's nothing looks like something. I'm not driving, it's driving me crazy. What's a city bus got that I don't have? I keep my light on. I keep the seat warm. But rust is all that feels real anymore.
Not driving drives you crazy. Get covered and go at safeauto.com.
I'm Andy, and I lost 30 pounds on Nutrisystem.
Listen up, guys. Want to shed a few pounds? Got a beer belly going on? Can't fit into your pants? I got one word for you, Nutrisystem.
I'm Essex, and I lost 43 pounds on Nutrisystem.
I'm Trevor, and I lost 60 pounds on Nutrisystem.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's all-new Turbo 10. You can lose weight, too. Real guys, real results.
I'm Michael, and I lost 50 pounds on Nutrisystem.
Put down the pie, pick up the phone, and get with the program today. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. You'll love it. Money back guarantee.
The food was delicious.
If you're like me and you like to eat, this is what you get to do.
This is perfect for men, especially guys who don't want to cook.
So get off the couch and order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now. Get 1 week of all new Turbo Shakes free and 1 week of NutriCrush Shakes free.
It's not that hard. You eat the food, you lose the weight.
Call 877-580-THIN and get the all new Turbo 10 with 14 shakes free.
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When the weather turns serious, you know, the first thing I'm thinking is, how do I communicate the message very clearly to people so they understand what the risk is and how to get through this?
Heat up, buddy. Don't get it this time.
Yeah.
Okay, not too quick.
Don't let go until I say so.
I got you.
Start strong with the lasting energy of 100% whole grain Quaker oats. And off you go.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer, our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
Pure is big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring, because Pure tastes better.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You pay no fees unless your case is settled. Don't fight this alone.
Please call 800-571-8403.
And of course, we continue our coverage of winter storm Kayla, and of course, all across parts of the upper Midwest and the plains getting hammered right now.
Blizzard warnings in effect. We're seeing either whiteout or near whiteout conditions and some thunder snow. You can see the lightning detection data showing up there around Des Moines, between Des Moines and Waterloo here in Iowa. Some of the wind gusts have been 40 to 50 mile an hour, even a little bit stronger than that at times, and the sustained winds 20 to 30, even close to 40 miles an hour, making it all very difficult to get around town.
Yeah, that's right. In dangerous conditions, if you're going to be trying to travel anywhere along Interstate I-80 or anywhere. Joining us right now, we have Roger Colcorth. He's with the Nebraska Department of Roads, and it looks like you have a big mess on your hand, especially right around I-80. We're looking at the area of Lincoln. Tell us how bad it is there.
Well, right now, Interstate 80 is closed here in Lincoln because District 4 to the west of us had closed it, so we shut it down here in Lincoln because if we let traffic go west, there's no place for them to go, and so we stop them here in Lincoln where we got food and lodging, and that's the only road other than Highway 34 west of Seward is becoming impassable, and we've got a snowplow stuck out there now.
So as far as the Department of Roads is concerned, will you give us an idea how big of a task this is when you're dealing with conditions like this?
Well, the biggest task right now is the wind. It's just blowing, and our visibility, say like out at Seward, which is to the west of Lincoln here, visibility is down to about 100 yards. And we go to the northwest of Lincoln and David City area, it's from 0 to 100 yards. And we're dealing with a lot of power outages, and we've got the David City snowplows trying to help the REA out there trying to get to these power outages, trying to get those back in running condition.
Yeah, you know, we do know that this is causing a major backup even into parts of Iowa. Are there any people out there actually stranded on the roadways?
We have not heard of anybody being stranded yet.
Roger, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Like I said, the only two roads right now is the interstate's closed westbound. We do have it open eastbound from the Seward Interchange, which is 379. We're keeping it open. But like I said, going west, District 4 had to shut it down because of semis in the road and stuck and stuff. And so the interstate is closed here in Lincoln.
And Roger, is there a point when conditions will get dangerous enough that you'll have to take the road crews, the guys and girls out there, the women out there working on the roads, is there a point where you have to pull everybody off and tell them to come back to base?
We did that already at David City earlier this morning. He said the visibility was so bad over there. And like I said, David City's northwest of here. And visibility was so bad, so they pulled the trucks off for a little while. But they got them back out there, and they're trying to help get these power outages going again.
All right, again, that is Roger Colcorth with the Nebraska Department of Roads. And you can see on the radar right now, the heavier snowfall continues to come down. Of course, the winds are creating problems, and we're going to continue to see that as we go throughout the day. We want to thank him for joining us. And of course, we will continue to see these road closures potentially at times. And this is a major stretch, especially for I-80. I looked on Google Maps, and you can see it's just backed up all the way across the state line.
And just looking at this right here, this is a live look from Chris Heater, who's been driving around giving us some reports. If there were not street signs in the immediate vicinity, you would have no idea where you are. As far as landmarks go, stores, drugstores, grocery stores, gas stations, you can barely see off the side of the road. So it gives you an idea of how dangerous it can be driving through conditions like this.
You know, if you get stuck on the side of the road and another car comes by, the visibility's down. They can't see you on the side of the road. This is so very dangerous. And then in addition to this, with the winds gusting at 52 at times across this park, it's going to continue to be this way as we go throughout the day.
A very serious winter threat we're following right now, and we'll continue to follow here on the Weather Channel. And as the day goes on, the severe threat increases. In fact, there is a significant tornado threat today, including Nashville.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here.
In my knees.
But now I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My knee pain.
Find a machine at drscholls.com.
Fact. Advil pain relievers are used by more households than any other leading brand. To treat their aches and pains, more people reach for Advil. Relief doesn't get any better than this. Advil.
date?
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Breathe. I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
When your cold makes you wish you could stay in bed all day, you need the power of new Theraflu Express Max. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning.
Mesothelioma victims and their loved ones may be entitled to a cash award from the $18 billion in asbestos trust funds, and you may not have to file a lawsuit to qualify. If diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call the number on your screen now. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and is passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer caused by exposure to asbestos. Many victims worked in the Navy or in shipyards, mills, carpentry, roofing, insulation, construction, or automotive industries. For over 30 years, our legal team has successfully helped thousands of victims and families. Time is limited. You may not have to file a lawsuit if you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos.
Call 1-866-688-8860. That's 1-866-688-8860.
09-4420.
When you start linking the people side up to the weather and the science and the data, it makes a real connection and starts, I think, drive home the importance of what we do.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8s, powered by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram.
Not everyone wants to follow the crowd, especially when they have a truck capable of taking them farther. And that's exactly what Ram 1500 can do, with the best fuel economy. It's this kind of leadership that has more people driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts, glory, Ram.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Across parts of the southeast, the temperatures have not been a problem over the last couple of days. That southerly flow ahead of what's over towards our west, our cold front. Today, we're going to see high temperatures in the 70s. As we go throughout the afternoon, we will see some storms firing up. You can almost see them on the contour line there, setting up across parts of Louisiana as well as in Memphis. You can see that coming a little bit later in the day. Kind of hard to tell there, but we do know that we have a real risk for tornadoes. And look at Atlanta. Atlanta is still struggling with the fog this morning.
And we are seeing a lot of those warm temperatures. So when you walk outside today and say, hey, something seems a little off, maybe that'll be a clue to pay attention to the weather later on today, because it's so important, because as the day goes along, the chance for severe weather will increase. This includes parts of Mississippi, parts of Tennessee, just to name a few. You can see all of the areas right here. And it's also possible we could see tornadoes at night.
Yeah, there's so many dangers coming along with this storm. And we also talk about what is going going to be happening wind-wise, and the winds are going to be a big story, but tornadoes are going to be a threat. We look ahead into the future. This is our high-resolution model. You can see those discrete cells, the supercells trying to pop up as we go later into the afternoon and evening hours.
And you can see Memphis is included in that. So let's get some local perspective right now. And joining us right now with a little bit of that perspective is Gary Woodall joining us via Skype. Gary, we appreciate you taking the time to speak with us from the National Weather Service in Memphis. As you look at the forecast, you look at the way the atmosphere is kind of shaping up today, what stands out in your mind?
Well, it's certainly going to be a busy day here in the Mid-South and all in the area where the severe weather risk is located. The big key for us is going to be how these storms evolve. And you were mentioning earlier the discrete cells. And the more we're able to see those separate to individual cells, of course, the greater the tornado risk will be. But we're really getting ourselves ready here at the office and certainly encourage everybody in the risk area to get their severe weather plans ready to go as well.
And you know, we do know that in addition to the winds, and we mentioned, of course, the discrete cells, but tornadoes are going to be a big concern, especially even as we go into the overnight hours.
Yeah, this system, as it continues on to the east, we'll see the development probably very near the Memphis area, just east of the Mississippi River this afternoon. But these storms will continue to progress eastward overnight. And, of course, here in the Mid-South, we do historically see a lot of overnight tornadoes. Mm-hmm. So just because the sun goes down doesn't mean the threat's necessarily going to be over.
And, Gary, does this setup remind you of anything, any particular event or a certain time of year?
Well, certainly, we had a few weeks ago the December 23rd tornadoes that affected, in particular, northern Mississippi. Mm-hmm. And, of course, we had the Super Tuesday outbreak back in February of 2008, I believe it was. And so we certainly can see significant severe weather in the area this time of year.
Yeah, you know, you're right. You mentioned the tornadoes that we saw earlier this year across parts of Mississippi. But, you know, this is pretty active pattern that we're in right now.
It really is. Mm-hmm. And you know, typically when we have an El Nino pattern, the strong El Nino that we're in, that does set the stage with a very strong and active southern portion of the jet stream. In some cases, it's further south than us and really affecting the Gulf Coast area. But for at least a couple times now, we've certainly had the potential for those the jet stream winds moving a little bit further north and putting us really in the active area here in the Mid-South.
Gary Woodall, thank you so much for your time and your perspective. And best of luck for the rest of the day and what's going to be a busy day for you and the rest of your team there at the National Weather Service in Memphis.
Yeah, you know, I think another part of the story, too, is how far north that severe weather threat is going to go for tonight as well.
And you can kind of tell when you go outside and you can feel that
warmth. You feel
warmth.
The soupiness. The winds are really going to be kicking up.
So the severe side, but also the winter side.
I think there's a severe side, too, with Kayla talking about the winds producing the blizzard conditions, making it really impossible to drive on the roadways across parts of the plains in the Midwest.
Coming up, where travel conditions are going to be nearly impossible, and the areas that are already shut down.
What you doing?
Just prepping for my boss's party in a couple weeks.
What are those?
Crest white strips. They whiten way better than paste.
Crest 3D white strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste.
I'd say someone's making quite an impression.
Crest 3D white strips, the way to whiten.
Across America, people are taking charge of their type 2 diabetes with non-insulin Victoza.
For a while, I took a pill to lower my blood sugar, but it didn't get me to my goal. So I asked my doctor about Victoza. He said Victoza works differently than pills and comes in a pen. Victoza is proven to lower blood sugar and A1C. It's taken once a day, anytime. Victoza is not for weight loss, but it may help you lose some weight.
Victoza is an injectable prescription medicine that may improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes when used with diet and exercise. It is not recommended as the first medication to treat diabetes and should not be used in people with type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Victoza has not been studied with mealtime insulin. Victoza is not insulin. Do not take Victoza if you have a personal or family history of medullary thyroid cancer, multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2, or if you are allergic to Victoza or any of its ingredients. Symptoms of a serious allergic reaction may include itching, rash, or difficulty breathing. Tell your doctor if you get a lump or swelling in your neck. Serious side effects may happen in people who take Victoza, including inflammation of the pancreas, pancreatitis. Stop taking Victoza and call your doctor right away if you have signs of pancreatitis, such as severe pain that will not go away in your abdomen or from your abdomen to your back, with or without vomiting. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you have any medical conditions. Taking Victoza with a sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar. The most common side effects are headache, nausea, diarrhea, and vomiting. Side effects can lead to dehydration, which may cause kidney problems.
If your pill isn't giving you the control you need, ask your doctor about non-insulin Victoza. It's covered by most health plans.
We know they're a great value, but to see if Malto Meal cereal tastes as good as they claim, we have assembled a panel of experts. Spoons are up. They are mid-crunch. And full thumbs! Malto Meal cereal. Thumbs up on great taste.
Here's something new. Now you can get the Weather Channel forecasts on the new L.L. Bean app. Just tap, shop, and discover. The new app from L.L. Bean, featuring forecasts from the Weather Channel. Download today.
Well, the squirrels are back in the attic.
Mom?
Your dad won't call an exterminator.
Can I call you back, Mom?
He says it's personal this time.
If you're a mom, you call at the worst time. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
Where are you? It's very loud there. Are you taking a Zumba class?
I really want there to be a venue where people who are trying to make a difference can have a voice and have a place to talk about their passions. Weather, climate, environment, technology, science. They're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy skies, low 72, winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, partly cloudy, high 79, winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.